back.
Barely missed on that EX launcher at the back.
Just caught him running in here with the sweep. And if that sweep was blocked, well, wow.
At that last round, he did actually do quite a few sweeps. So if any of them had blocked, it would have been curtains. But, you know, they weren't.
So right now, we're going to go for a quick 5 minute break. I say quick 5 minute. We're going to go for a 5 minute break. And when we come back, we're going to proceed with the top. I think we're into top four now.
Yeah,
we're into top four. So we're gonna proceed to the top four, which is going to be in winner's final.
Yeah.
We're going to have JDCR versus Kuiper.
You've seen this before.
How many times?
You got to focus.
And who we got
losing? And then in losers, we're going to have Super Akuma coming up against Peruvian Hero at the moment. I wonder if he's not caught in that water.
I don't know, who knows? I mean, again, all about weather.
Yeah, I guess Mario's going to have to really think about how he's going to lose that. Who's going to have his mind? He's a very intelligent player. So I'm pretty sure know that when Akuma has that bar, he's going to have to probably KO. Wait up.
Yeah, sometimes
it's back.
Round two.
So guys, we're going to have a quick break. Stay tuned.
Round one. Fight. Fight. Round one. Fight. Round one. Fight.
Ladies and lads, we are now in the top four of this Masters event here in Lyon. We've already had an amazing top eight, and I'm sure
you're
going to be crazy.
It's going to be crazy. We've seen so many from this top eight to top four. I'm sure we've seen something that's probably going to live on for how long. I'm sure people are going to still be talking about this. How many hills have you been?
Seven. Boy, it has been a crazy top eight so far. And now we are moving into the winners' side of the top eight. Winners climb, right?
So, you've already got the mind games starting. Pack will win at the coin toss off stream.
Yeah.
So we can talk about. Okay, so I'm going to make sure we have an announcement in a bit, but quite quickly, let me tell you the characters, the players in the top four. We have Super Kong, Liu Kang, both in winners, and Kaifa and JDCR, both in winners.
And how many times have you seen Kaifa and JDCR in that winner side? Like,
nous allons passer au top chat de ce Tekken World Tour, Tekken Drum Battle. Time for the top four of the Tekken World Tour event, Tekken Drum Battle. win Echo Fox GDCR! Arkham Kuiper! Crazy Super Akuma and RGFM Rukang! Make some noise! Du bruit!
It was pretty bad for Kuiper. He got
but hold on. Yes. So these two have lived with each other.
They have. Jody's just stayed at Kuiper's house.
And it looks like Kuiper has pulled out.
Bad for Claudio.
Have you seen Kuiper play Claudio?
Yes, he actually. That was his first character when, back in Tekken 7.0. Right. And they had. There was a tournament, Tekken 7.0 tournament in Sweden. Kuiper JCL was the grand final.
Yeah.
Kuiper
round
won.
One. Yeah, I remember that.
Fight.
But this is a different ball game.
Those hop kicks, Claudio's hop kick, really one of those annoying hop kicks in the game. This is kind of like a smash hop kick.
Yeah, it does seem to hype the quite a bit, so
he's putting a lot of pressure on the high pop plays. He doesn't want to be at the school, but kind of stepping out.
Yeah, it seems like they're kind of getting going to use right now.
Kaifor with that starburst still, he's going to open that packet. Nice throw break. Yeah, he opened the starburst there. No, Space does not want it. Not one at all. He's going to have a strawberry flavor.
Oh,
round two.
He's so strong.
And the pop kick just doesn't work.
One more mix up and that
very unfortunate, the pop kick caught him airborne, so he didn't get
the ball. He had the right idea, but just...
So what's your take on Claudio as a character?
So I don't think he's an incredibly strong character, but if your movement is obviously content, you can utilize that
tool. Round three.
You could do a lot of work. 4-3 of course also.
Yeah, 4-3 that's the
Holding mid. Stop. Right now, GDCR seems to be one step ahead.
I really feel that with Claudio, it's really hard for an opponent to open the box. Yes. If you're really defensive, I feel it doesn't really work. I see that.
Yeah.
Kuiper should really open GDCR. You get a walk on ball.
Lucky that he's going to duck down. This is also 1-3. He's going to get a perfect.
Oh, unlucky.
Oh, the launch. That does launch at the
water. Certain angles, you'll get a full launch on our forward score. Trying to make a comeback. One wall spot and it could be over, but great.
Nice. Good down jump, yeah? That down two is not plus on, on normal hits. So, Kuiper challenged it. Down 4-2 now. Take that to the wall.
This is where Kuiper does not want to be. Does not want to have his back against the wall. JDCR.
Well, he's stepping left now. Trying to get himself out of that situation.
Nice. Low parry on down two.
And I feel that if you want to punish him, use that wall, you have to low parry.
Yeah.
Nice great. Duck on that Warren 2 though.
Side move that saved him. Down 2. And he opts to go for the slide.
It's
something he's more and jungle plays usually now. It's that slide.
Yeah. So he has good buff. Twice it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What's the buff? As well, especially as you kind of slide on in, it can add like a load that you wouldn't really expect from that kind of range.
Yeah, definitely. It allows Dragon to have a mixed up.
Especially if you don't need to use your unit once, you can throw it out every now and again from the surprise.
And I'm sure he would use it, knowing that that character.
And this is a
first.
I respect that. You know, going out.
And I know why he went to because he is casually used it, but the thing is,
it really did go well. It's really knowing playing well. We see the play against one of the best players in the world, using him.
Exactly, and you know what, just
round
there,
three.
JDCR is awake, his with punishment is on point, but I would say that back on the counter.
Down four. And then that Kempo starts at this one, trying to make this job with a running two.
Nice, he used that holding move.
Nice, back turn, down four.
Yeah, now, one thing that, you know, you you want to be good against the very fundamental thing. Are those homies?
Yeah.
I don't think enough people use it. And Jay Xiao walks around people.
And he's got great moves and great fundamentals. He knows when to step.
Yes.
Aimlessly, like a wild, you know, wild DD. Step in specifically, and this will be the round.
Hyper started that round quite well, but there's always a purpose behind the step.
He's always stepping ahead.
Tempo starts there, quickness of work.
Tempo starts being put into work a lot.
We've seen a lot of tempo starts.
He's gonna get full combo off of this.
Oh, not quite.
Okay. I'm gonna definitely get full combo off of this.
Are you trying to get it?
Okay, also got the OP, got the combo. Just a bomb, kind of bomb, like a shoulder bar.
I wonder if Feng's hop kick actually wanted that.
Yeah, we say this, I think I remember you saying it. Feng's hop kick doesn't really have the greatest range.
It doesn't. It actually has, like, it probably has the least range from hop kick in the game.
Yeah. So he'll have to opt to go for just a shoulder bar at that kind of range.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
And we go down to the hop kick.
Alright, here we go.
That was minus 10 if we did the hop kick.
Why not?
Yeah, man, you got to go for it sometimes.
But we read that he's going to go for a down two again, or a down four.
Nice, that's a counter hit. Big damage.
Right, the back turn, bro. What's the mix up now? He gets caught airborne, he's going to get a full flat. Goes for a down two, and while standing down four.
Nice, right, Jiddy Shot trying to low parry there. That's the wrong reason. The Kaifa is making some good decisions.
Yeah, Kaifa, you know, there's two rounds to keep. Probably really need this game to equalize this.
Yeah, definitely. You don't want to let JDCR go too up.
Yeah, I don't remember seeing JDCR losing from two games advantage ever.
No, I think so. Yeah. So once he had the momentum. But here we go, he's looking really strong. Hey. What's the mix up?
Drops the side step four. Got a bit too greedy there.
Round two.
Somebody drops the combo though.
Okay, nice one, three.
And
takes it. Down four, two, two for the win.
And a key charge as well for good measure. So down four, two, two. It's a safe. So it was a good way to finish off the round.
Yeah, just making too much of a commitment, didn't want to be blocked punishing because you know you can't punish this. You can't kind of say, hey, can you punish this? No. JDCR will punish it.
He punishes stuff that you don't think people can punish. So like, I was using Eddie Vessel, so I was playing it, and I didn't sidestep back before, which is a really good thing.
Round three.
Like he baited it out. I thought he had to go. And you know, people figure out too late that, oh god. But Kaifa, of course, these guys are playing so much.
Yeah, like you said, they've lived together.
They've lived together, yeah. And they're staying together today as well. Like,
you've been salty, you know, way back.
Losing, isn't it? Third game, one round.
He's got commanded life lead already. 5 seconds gone, and Kaifa's nearly dead.
Turned up the heat.
Yeah. Nice, bring him back to number one. To alleviate the pressure, didn't want to deal with any of Kaifa's
offense.
That was such a clean whip punish. And is he going to be the round?
Yes.
Just enough, the last hit doing it.
And it's not just the fact that he can whip punish on reaction, it's the fact that he moves and in order to make you whip and then punish you. He knows
exactly.
Where to
be. Yeah, he's got a really good mindset of what you want to do, and nice counter hit confirmed from Kaifa.
Oh, just runs at him again. He's got his wall pressure now. Can he keep JDCR there?
Yes, definitely. That's where he wants to be. He wants to lock him down. Feng with strong options to wall slap.
Yes, definitely. Oh, the nose. This time, JDCR does not respect it.
Fight.
Okay, while running two. Get himself out of the wall with that.
Uh-oh, he doesn't get hit by it.
He tried to tempo something, hit that whip, but got blocked.
Oh, the downstairs again, this might be it.
If he goes downstairs, he's definitely going to be right. Yeah, definitely going to beat around.
Nice, down 4-4. So, it's going to be from him, but Kaifa got him out of
the team. No, Kaifa's been playing for him as well.
It looks like he's winning the round. He's going to get that kick. Yeah. Down 4-2.
He's making his timing on stepping really well, right? Well, able to get a whip punish.
Yeah, I think, you know, Kaifa's gonna have to try to alleviate that by either realigning my sidestep and dashing. Cannot let JDCR decide to walk around.
Yeah, once again, he is winning this round, but is he gonna throw it away?
This is where he's gotta be careful.
Very careful indeed.
Really seeing how clutch he can be.
That's once again. Probably trying to bait JDCR into something. Nice, block punish, sorry.
Boy, all the way back, he's actually winning now.
That's just a hot kick. No respect.
No respect. Hot kick. And like you said, you got to do that sometimes.
Yeah,
you
show your hold three.
That I'm not scared to do it.
Yeah, you got the challenge. And JC has a very smart player. He's going to pay the back of his head.
Steps all the way around.
Yeah, just keep going the wall back. 4-3 is what he's looking for. Hey, he gets the
he's locking down Tyson right now. Not letting him do it.
Has to make this comeback. JC has been a good keep out here. Very good keep out, but
it's kind of stop it now.
Okay, no count here. But then that's a big whip punch.
It looks like he's kind of doing it.
Jadizar was
I'm still ready to fight.
And the thing with what people say about Kuna, right? They play in the safest way possible.
Yeah.
That's their play style, right? With the exception of a few players, of course, but generally, they try to play really safe.
One of the exceptions that just came to their mind was Soldam.
Yeah, Soldam. Soldam, and you got. That's their play style. Was insane. Like, yeah. Saint, he's got that as well. Like, he can play.
Oh,
like
definitely,
Saint,
yeah,
but
Saint.
Then he got ham sometimes.
Round one.
I played Saint, and. I wasn't prepared for how the playstyle was. Yeah. It really like hit me back. I was like, whoa. Are you supposed to be like, let me do some offense in the back
there? I'm just supposed to let him come in on
me. Yeah. No. You're supposed to defend against me and show me that my offense is whack.
Exactly.
But this guy was like, no, I'm going to attack you and show you that your defense is whack.
Exactly, yeah. So that's what you're getting. Exactly what you said. He shows you that their offense. One backdash, one sidestep.
That's something that gets comfortable with a lot of games. Yeah. As you see, JDCR, I'm sure everyone knows that he's such a well-traveled guy now.
Yes, absolutely.
Everywhere, so he's probably picked up a lot of that worldly play styles now, and see how maybe some of the American players can play South America. That was very cheap. He just stayed in JDCR's face. Back turn. How risky is that?
Yeah, I mean, obviously JDCR could have pressed the button, but he hasn't been.
No.
And you don't usually, at that point, you don't usually do that, right? So, like,
and in that kind of situation, when he let Kuiper get in his face back turn, it then became a legit 50-50.
It did, yeah. But, you know, JDCR has been guessing right in those 50-50s, and, you know, hasn't taken it. So Kuiper just mixed up his timing. That's what you got to do.
Yeah, exactly. He actually stayed in his face for such a long time. JDCR actually ducked.
Yeah,
but, okay, the downfall must be coming.
You know, JDCR is human. He's going to react to that really well. Nice way to go.
That's going to be round.
Yeah.
Kind of, yeah. Some sort of damage.
Yeah, kind of. That's what it's like, something you get back into. Like, sometimes it's
It's one of the things that you get when you play Tekken a long time. Sometimes you just know what your point is. It's like you're living in the zone, you're living in their head, rent free. It's like, I don't need to do this right now.
And why did you see that slide?
Yeah.
That is a cool disruption versus
Kakashi. There's a lot of back lines there. Oh, no count here.
Round 3.
JDCR's got all the space now to make Kaifa come to him.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. And then he caught him ducking.
But this is, again, another very close round. These rounds have not been close at all.
Yeah, last was about even now. That's just a down for two from nowhere. This is going to be the game.
Nice range diving. JDCR taking over Kaifa 3-1 and moves on into Grand.
Yeah, it's interesting to see what would have happened if he went straight from the beginning.
It really didn't work.
Fake was a lot more solid. JDCR a lot more trouble.
Yeah, definitely.
Much closer. That's how I would have liked to see the fake.
But yeah, it's just kind of seems like JDCR.
Round 2.
He makes you come in. Get you tired out. It's like Mayweather McGregor. Yeah, it really just seemed like, you know, if you get the right read on JDCR, you can stop it. It's a good tactic.
Yeah.
The read is so good, you know, he'll most of the time get the strike.
Yeah. I guess it's all that like damage that gauge him. Go to the one.
Yeah.
I mean, some damage he kind of just, you know.
Yeah, his movement's going to be surrounded, it's going to be revolved around making sure he gets the damage as well.
Yeah. Z head. Look at the timing change. He just really stayed there, took the risk. Back turn very dangerous, Ted.
Yeah.
He cannot block.
No, he's not.
KO. Round 4.
Yeah.
That was
fight.
I think we're going to have another announcement. One with the. I was about to say Spanish, or possibly French PO.
Yeah, we're getting mixed up all the time.
You got this mix up flag.
Oh,
I'm blocking this. I can't get that.
So let's talk about
We've got Babs. They're going to have Super Raze
KO
Rafuma versus
final round.
Kang.
That's sometimes very bad. Like some players are extremely good on P1 and some are very bad on P1.
Yeah.
And especially now that set of nine is so good. You don't have your
Le match avant la finale loser. Qui va essayer de se trouver à nouveau pour affronter ce super. Les super Akuma, RBFM, Wu-Tang, applaudissez. Last match before the final losers. Crazy Super Akuma and RBF Wu-Tang. Let's go!
Yeah, so we're gonna have, we just got that announced. Now it's gonna be very interesting because I don't think I've seen these two guys play at all.
No, I haven't either, and you know, Wu-Kang, he does play online. These both guys play online, so maybe they've had some experience online with each other. But it really comes down to does Wu-Kang know the matchup?
Yes. Does Wu-Kang know the matchup, or is Wu-Kang gonna just go? You know what? You're crazy, Super Mario. I'm gonna send that crazy.
We've already seen that Wu-Kang is crazy. We should change it to crazy Wu-Kang. Actually, We all you've known his trade for years now.
Yeah, but I think he solidified it with those six or seven health seats.
Man did it on the big stage. It doesn't matter where he is, he's so experienced. And I don't think people really notice that enough. He is very experienced in tournaments. He's been all over the place. So many tournaments.
Better for sure. But it's we said, we mentioned there's, you know, Akuma matchup, but it's crazy Super Akuma ready for the Rukan matchup.
KO. That's true, yeah. I mean, on the other hand, you had crazy Super Akuma deal with the Vortex that we
talked about. Vortex, I've named this now, Rukan Vortex. Once he gets that one health sweep on you, it gets into your mind. People, I don't think people understand until they actually play against Rukan. It's easy just to see it and be like, oh, I'll do X, Y, and Z.
It's like a billion people go to your head when you get in the vortex.
And especially when you're up on this stage, on this cabinet with a crowd going crazy behind you.
With a guy with a popcorn.
Yes.
Exactly. You know, it's a different situation, guys. Let's get into it. Loser side. So much on the line here.
Marion's dashed up running for a hop kick already. Certain that, you know, I'm going to be crazy.
Looks like he does have some punishment there.
Now, interestingly, Akuma can use them to single catch for your bubble. Can't punish it.
Oh, yeah.
This match is getting a bit crazy now. So Marion, he tried to jab in there, but just a bit unlucky. Probably a bit too late with the jab.
Oh, no, launch punish there. He hit the right button.
There we go. Akuma going to...
I knew it, man! I knew it was coming! Rukan didn't. So first round, Super Akuma.
Starts off with a... I'm at 1 plus 2, you see? Mario likes to start off with that attack.
He does. That's the thing we talked about. The Vortex is... There are options for him against that Vortex. He just used the SDP.
Yeah.
Okay, this is going to be huge damage.
Yeah, definitely goes for the spring kick. Watch the mix-up. Like that, he just backdashes out. He's scared of a DP.
Yeah.
Super Akuma didn't quite have the meter for an EX DP, so he wouldn't have been invincible.
Nice, good
touch. Stop.
I think Super Akuma was just trying to gauge what does Rukan know
about Akuma. Yeah.
Nice combo video.
Okay, here we go.
He's
gonna do it again. the EX DP, but I guess it's cool. He made him use the meter, and he's still got a healthy life lead, but it may not be healthy after this.
No, he's gonna have to do another mix-up. If Rukan is clever, he'll stay on the ground and not deal with it. Oh, never
mind. Just break kicks, why not? Okay, runs into a fireball. Very careful when he's gonna press. You see Akuma's damage in combos.
This is definitely the pro end for Akuma. His combo damage is insane. Keep that with his fireballs.
Rukan just blocking those fireballs. He doesn't want to do anything. He's playing very patient. Nice jab.
Oh my god,
this could potentially be the round. He's got that bar, catches him, stays down.
Ah, nice! Finishes it! Rukan!
That is very risky though, because off of Bob's jab, there's no mix-up.
So you can always duck it.
You can always low parry, but Super Akuma's not ready.
Two rounds up here.
Okay, gets a spring kick. Okay, Rukan playing very patient now, but has the life deficit.
Definitely the big life deficit there. He's going to have to do something.
This is going to be the game. Oh no, it's not. He misses it. But yeah, that's going to be a punish.
Okay, so now we're on a final round and Akuma does not have any meter here.
Yeah.
But he has a meter for no bars. He got bars.
Interesting start with a DP. DP again. Super Akuma showing that he's crazy too.
Yeah, but can Bob actually launch those?
I don't think he can.
Mix up tiny duck.
Catches his duck in. Now you're in the vortex. Nice awareness from Mario, but drops a combo. Health sweep. What are we going to do?
Nice conversion.
Goes for the...
good punish on the power crush.
Yeah, power crush. Very careful.
Oh no, this could be big damage.
It's just going to hit.
No, it doesn't hit. And a get up kick. Hey, Rukan pops off. Rukan gets really angry.
Just to reiterate to you guys, this is a first to two.
This is, we're still in first to two territory. So, Super Akuma, it's your last chance, mate.
Can Mario ascend and really... Is this Mario's tournament?
It looks like it is. This is where he's breaking out. This is where he's saying, do you know what? People didn't trust me. People didn't believe me when I was at my low. But this is where I show what I'm made of.
But
round one. I don't know what they're saying.
It sounds like Akuma and Ryu Kang at the same time.
No, they're saying something in French, but it sounds like they're saying Ryu Kang.
I know.
So imagine Ryu Kang's like, yo, they're cheering for me. You know, he's like that, and he'll be like, yo, guys, I didn't know. Yeah, Ryu.
Nah, look how focused he is. He's not listening to anything. He is so focused. He is in this game. He knows how much this match means to him.
How much money there is in this one match.
And
how
point,
much points
he wants to get on that leaderboard. Hell sweet.
There's no beats to worry about at the start of the match, so he can be a
bit more. Is in the back. Kay tries to catch a duck in.
Okay, super Akuma now on the offense.
He's holding back, that's what he can't do. Has to try at least nice left.
But he has a light beat now.
Okay,
rival.
Oh no. Big damage here.
It's going to be a huge combo from Super Akuma. Goes to the springboard, but the sweep.
Yeah.
Taking it.
He's done that quite a few times now, and I think Super Akuma is.
Trying to catch on. Nice duck. I think he's trying to catch it running into the cannonball.
Maybe, yeah. Oh,
okay,
damn.
Nice. Okay, here we go. This is the Mario Vortex. Goes for the neutral jump.
Neutral jump. Oh no, Bob's back at the wall now. Ooh,
gets caught. Nice combo. Ree rules by Akuma showing that he knows his character.
Nice.
Goes to the low again. Pro Tank does not care.
He doesn't care, lads. He don't care.
You know, long hair, don't care, Ryu Kang.
Yeah,
hell, oh no, let's not again. Okay,
no, not
super
this time.
No, we only got to two this time.
Two counts.
I wonder if he's going to go for it again. I have a sneaky suspicion that he's going to go for it.
Oh no, well, that's a mind game, right?
Nice,
there we
hell
go.
Sweet.
He's going to go for it again. No, not
no,
this time.
One too many.
And Bob, can he kill from it?
I don't think he can kill. If he gets to the wall, then yeah. We need to be very careful.
No,
that's going to be it. No, it's not going to be the round. That's going to be punishable, but gets the sweep instead.
Okay, so some reason not going there for Ryu Kang at the moment.
Quick swing of trick before. And a block at the health seat.
Okay, here we go. This is where Ryu Kang has to think about it. Those health seats are not working now.
Yeah, okay. Catches him in the air, and the card is going wild Super Akuma.
Every hit that he gets, the card
is
going wild.
And this is
going
to be it.
Seven golden.
And the crowd is going wild.
This is the last French person in the tournament. The French, like we said all day, these guys are the hype in Europe.
They are so passionate.
Yes.
So passionate.
They are behind that boy 100%. 1-1. The winner of the next match is going on. More points, way more money. This
but
is all the same.
Look at Mario, he doesn't look fazed. But Akuma's feeding off this French crowd. He's really feeding off this French crowd.
He does. I've seen him play at multiple tournaments in France. You know what? Yeah, I saw him playing on the stage in Al. And you know, he had a close set with almost beat me. And it was a crowd that was giving him energy, right?
Yeah. It's like in football, but they say 12th man. The crowd is the 12th man. This is that additional. This is the additional, I don't know, rage damage. I don't know how to call it. It's something, the additional.
Yeah, this is the support, man. It's
yeah, it's the additional support.
But let's watch it now. We're back at the same stage.
Okay, Mario obviously still put one
yeah.
Nice punish.
Got a bit more.
Oh, catches him. There we go. Now Mario's starting to mix it up with the mid.
Yes. It's all mixed up.
Says you want to duck? Okay, duck this mid.
Oh! Absorbs that hit.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I think Mario, that's why Super Akuma is going for those focus attacks.
Man, Hopkins is out of that jump.
Yeah. Mario in a commanding position now. Okay, playing less crazy.
One more hit's going to do it. Get yourself out of that wall.
He needs to definitely position himself away from the wall. Chases down his fireball. And that's a legit punish. And this could potentially be the round. If he gets, no, he drops it.
One more miss, did it.
Down three.
So Ryu Kang has been using that string a lot to finish round.
Yes, I actually told him it's not a string he should be using. A hot kick.
Okay, so just started the round again by Ryu Kang. Let's see if he can ride off his system. Oh.
Yeah, see if he just did not want to deal with any mix-up.
Oh, is he in a launch attack? Yes,
yes,
he does.
Yes, the hot kick, but the combo drops.
So much to play for, man. He must be super nervous.
Super Akuma with the jab tap to show you can. Is he gonna go to the wall? Is he gonna get a wall combo? No. And this is gonna be
really
a punish. No, it's a bit late. Oh. So Super Akuma now really commanded his two rounds up. This is game point for Super Akuma.
Yeah, Ryu Kang starts every round really well, but it just makes those really risky mistakes.
Yeah, and I've noticed he's not going for health anymore.
Yeah.
It's that Super Akuma scared him with all that blocking.
Yeah, definitely. And you know, the hit happened
earlier. As I say it now, here we go. Health sweep again. Health again. Okay. And that's a nice bait.
I don't think he meant to do that.
I think he did.
Really?
I think he did. He went to shut down Mario's offense. I think he didn't want Mario to get started.
Oh,
I think he's going to be in the back. Okay, wait for the hot thing. He's going to duck.
But that is a launch punish against Akuma.
Yep. Definitely. Oh, no. And this is going to be a huge combo. Gets the back one combo. Nice steps again, and this is going to be in the back.
So well.
No, a bit too greedy there. This could potentially be the game. Okay, it's not the game. Mario has one.
Oh, that could have been it.
That could have been
it. And that helped
the health
again.
And Super Koopa's just like, okay.
Yes. So those health sheets, man, definitely not working out that time for Ryu Kang, but wow, what an awesome
I wonder what would have happened if Mario done started to mix up Shoryukins in there.
Yeah, I mean, do you know what? If you do Shoryukin there,
yeah,
he's still going to launch you if you do Hot Kick or Shoryukin. As you saw, the jab into the EX bar.
Yeah.
So maybe he should, yeah,
I just reckon that would have really thrown Super Koopa. I think one Shoryukin would have been like, this guy's a bit too crazy.
Yeah, this guy's crazy to me. Yeah,
yeah,
but like,
I think he got a bit too predictable with the health sweeps.
Of course, is that mixed up? Like, is he going to do it?
Yeah, but I think he should have maybe held back a little
and
bit.
And I know that he does have, Bob has a good option from Wave Dash, because Wave Dash holds on those two. And
isn't that? Yeah, Wave Dash one from the two, actually.
And he has to use that as an option.
You know, when you're in the tournament, when you're in the world, when you're in the zone, like you said, Ryu Kang really plays off how he feels, and you know that.
Okay, man. And you know what? His feelings are this right. He's taking the world place. That's a grand.
Yeah.
A lot of bucks.
Well done
to
Ryu Kang.
Good point as well.
Definitely good point. So I guess he's gonna be the loser.
The loser. Find the tail.
Oh, but yeah. Sorry, we forgot about the replay.
Before that, yeah, checking out the replays.
Just an ESDB is like, you know what, I don't want no mid, no low, no nothing, just an ESDB.
You know, you're so close, but I feel like he didn't really play the match,
Yeah. That's one of the things I've kind of said about Akuma. I feel like you have to actually play Akuma at times. Yeah. See here, the ring.
Yeah, that was punished.
Yeah, pop-up. Pop up to the French crowd, I guess that's doing the fire.
You really started to get, like, start most rounds with this one.
Yeah.
And then, you know, because of his risky playstyle, he doesn't end up giving away.
Yeah, that's the way Ryu Kang plays, just his style.
Yeah, he can either give you the win in the most spectacular way, or you get the loss.
Exactly. What's it, living by the sword, dying by the sword?
Yeah, that's the perfect way to describe Ryu Kang.
Yeah.
Live by the sword, and then die by the sword. But that's what makes for entertaining matches, man. Tell me one guy that's going to be more entertaining than Ryu Kang, man.
Definitely today, from that health sweep thing, that's going to be that highlight of the day.
Definitely.
And obviously the man in the match, the play of the day.
Play of the day, man.
Play of the day. We should start as a thing. You know, every technical world will have play of the day.
Play of the day.
Yeah.
Yeah,
who knows? It's not over, yeah. Definitely top three in the store here. Went for the health once in the time.
Yeah.
And then the French crowd did that pop off.
Could have mixed up the time a little bit again, and it just took over it straight away.
Yeah.
Final round.
But yeah, it just wasn't thinking, you know. You're in the moment. I just want to play by
four. Yeah. So we've got here now, we're going to be in the losers finals.
The losers finals, man, again.
We've seen this, right?
We've seen, I don't think we've seen, have
we
seen this?
Was Kaipa at Demolition?
Yes, but he got knocked out by Kuma.
Oh, yeah.
So this is the second time in a row that Super Kuma had a losers finals. With JD Stark, he would have been this. Is that it? Yes.
Yeah. Interesting. So we're gonna have announcement. Very, very, very soon.
This is gonna be a good match. I don't think you've seen this guy today.
So yeah, here we go, guys.
Interesting.
So we're gonna have announcement. Okay, a little bit delay, but yeah, here we go. He's walking off with the mic.
Et la finale loser, final loser of this second Grand Battle, Tekken World Tour Event, la finale de ce Tekken Grand Battle, tournoi Tekken World Tour, opposera Akam Kuiper contre Super Akuma. Make some noise!
Heard that noise.
It's no secret here who the crowd is supporting, man.
Yeah,
the low hula.
again. There's no mistaking who is the crowd favorite.
So, like I said before, you know what? I actually think the Kaipa did play Sukuma.
Whoa.
He's already today.
Yeah. Definitely.
Oh, they did Sukuma the up 4-2, right? How important that is.
Yeah. And I want. Yeah, so I wonder if we're going to see it again. If Kaipa is really going to, you know, remember his strategy against Sukuma and go to it.
Yeah, because I don't really think that Super Kuma really plays too different.
Yeah, and he didn't really adapt to it, but as you say, now he's really running riot on Kaipa,
yeah.
Just really going in.
Yeah, going in. You caught him ducking, caught him with his pants down, took that first round.
Oh, nice conversion, catches that blow.
Definitely, and the dash is 4-2 as well. Not easy to do.
Got to be very careful because Kuma does have that bar. We know that Super Kuma is not afraid to defend it.
He's better now. But yeah, it's not, like you said before, it's not really the worst thing in the world.
Yeah.
Get rid of that user. I don't mind.
Yeah. You don't want him to kind of use it for the FADC combos because that's when it becomes a real problem.
Yeah,
when he's getting.
Oh god.
Yeah, when he's getting that 80% damage. Yeah.
Try to step by step the wrong way.
There we go.
He's gonna go towards the wall.
Goes towards the wall, but no wall.
Time.
Gets the wall slap, but no. Ah, nice reaction to the side step four.
Super really ducking these going towards the lows, getting a lot of mileage for these games.
Now just using that jump back fire, which is key out of face range.
Oh, gets the defense back. Oh, use that.
He tried to, yeah, it was a good attempt at the combo, but.
What a whip punish, wow.
Is this gonna be the game?
It might be.
Woo! Double shoulder barge, great aware combo, great position combo awareness from Kaipa.
Yeah, get a wall splat from like midstream. Why not?
Why not?
Take that all day.
Okay, off to go for the Deep Slip cancel. Yeah, he's not using that 4-2 anymore. I wonder if he's just in the zone where he's forgotten about it.
Yeah, perhaps. Who knows? Final round. That wasn't really good damage in the last round.
Yeah, it was really that. Or maybe saving it to like the last round when he needs it.
Maybe he is up here right now.
Ooh, that could have been a big whiff punish.
There
you go.
And just
headbutt this. Where are you going, sir? Where are you jumping, sir?
I'm gonna head out. But this is first with you guys now.
First three. We're in top three.
Yeah. So these guys can have their 15 caps on. Maybe I'll do the Lotus.
Low?
Yeah.
Why not? It works.
Deep mind games, ladies and lads.
Maybe he should do a Rude Kang just go for 6 sweeps in a row.
Yeah, do it.
Why not?
Let's get into it. So Kaipa 1-0 up, looking to get back into that grand final.
And now we got the up 4-2s. Yep, the up 4-2s are now coming out prominently.
Yep, definitely.
Nice punish.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, it doesn't suck.
That headbutt quite a bit.
So I wonder if that headbutt is actually legit to keep the Kuma out of the air, because it seems like it catches him floating.
Yeah, yeah.
Round one. Kaipa.
Seems like he definitely has done his homework.
He needs to be very careful about throwing fireballs, but he's seen.
Nice step.
Okay, we should get. Oh. That shit out. That's both back, that shit out, but. Oh!
The shoulder!
Woo! Just catches everyone to the down three. And that's the thing, like I say, down three has a slow start. So that quick miss can be it.
Yeah, so like you said before, down forward one. Oh,
yeah.
Down forward two. That's
yeah. Definitely, when you're in a Kuma's face, especially as Peng, down forward one is really going to be your go-to move and up forward two.
This guy's attacking his shoes, man. Wait. Oh, yeah, he got shoes.
Yeah,
okay,
he's got them kind of special sandals on.
Attacking the sandals.
Doesn't have the bar, but that is a like that is an actual punish.
Oh really?
Yeah.
I mean, it was a punish.
Wow. Fireword that range on here is punishable. I'm sure.
So the crowd trying to get Super Kuma amped up for this, just as they do.
There we go.
Big damage.
This is gonna go to the wall.
Are you serious?
Yeah, he drops it.
Drops a combo and hits that much damage.
Yeah. We can't say that's a combo drop. Let's call it a reset.
Yeah. So, Super Kuma on the board now. Definitely don't want to go 2-0 down, man.
Yeah.
But he has got into that position now, lose the finals. Doesn't matter. If he does lose the next match, he still has it.
Definitely has the opportunity. Yeah, it is first to three.
Oh,
what? Teleports back into Bank.
What was that?
And this could potentially be it. Yeah.
Tempo stance again.
That is a tremendous whip punish.
It gets damage. It doesn't get clean wall stack though.
Yeah. But one more. This could potentially be it. If he gets the. Oh, I think he tried to go for the Raging Demon.
Messes up the Raging Demon. Yeah. It's all about one more mix-up.
And that is such a great whiff punish from Kaipo. So ready.
So ready and aware, you know, like just staying at that range. Knows what his options are, what he wants to do, and he just executes perfectly.
Yeah. I'm sure when the Super Cool got the fireball there, I'm sure he went for the 1-1 towards 2+3 for the Raging Demon. And I think he kind of got the fireball motion. I'm sure in that kind of instance, he wants to go for the Rage Arc, the Rage Demon.
Yeah.
He's got a fireball in that situation.
Yeah.
I think whatever happens, he will be number one. Actually, no, because he's super human with
He wins this, he'll be number one. So this is all to play for. This is for that number one spot.
Howard's still behind their play. Super Puma, want to see him excel. Want to see him succeed in this match. Got intro poses. Just flying over that balcony. There we go. Kaipa, two games up.
One more, and he's going to get the grand finals.
Yeah, he's going to have that run back. Either way, it will be a run back. If Super Puma makes a comeback, it'll be the Demolition Derby run back.
That's what
he gets. That is, huge, the punch parry there. And
it seems like Fake has so many options to do in this matchup.
And again, dunking on him. He has to be very careful. He has that bar.
That
and he just doesn't care. He's not caring about Kuma's bar.
It doesn't matter because if he gets hit by that EXP, what's the worst that's going to happen? Getting hit by it,
it's
a little bit of damage.
I think in range it doesn't quite a bit of damage.
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah.
Big damage in chunks right now.
That's Super Goon just making the wrong read. Oh, but I say this, got the combo, but it's still tremendous damage.
Good punish there.
Just for the fish hook. Keep it honest. Oh, goes for the throw, and it's not it. Back it off, Super Kuma's scared.
Oh, and that's gonna hit! No, it's not gonna hit! His shoes weren't big enough!
Oh.
Just out of range.
Spaghetti. I actually thought that kick was gonna go over his head and I was gonna lose my mind. Super Kuma there taking it in a clutch solo.
He doesn't get the DP. Counter hit, nice. Yeah, full combo there.
Yeah, we go towards the wall.
That turned up.
Nice. And it's going to be guaranteed shoulder.
That was really good there. Holding forward against the Demon Smith. That's the knowledge. That's what we haven't seen all day.
Yeah, going underneath and getting the guaranteed shoulder barge. He goes also go for the jab punish. Could have gone for a hot kick.
This is it. This is match point for Kaipa. If he wins this, he will be number one in the European leaderboard.
Okay, so much to play for. Okay, jabs down two. Super Kuma in a really bad position here. Doesn't need this round. He really needs this round to drive the momentum back. Otherwise, it's game over.
Definitely. What a clutch throw break as well. He has the life lead. It seems like he wants to keep him out, but the pressure from Kaipa right now.
Kaipa just seems like he has all the answers. He just knows what he wants to do. As I say that, sweet. Using the jump back fireball.
And the sweep
again.
This seems like Kaipa's is like staying in that range like a python ready to attack,
ready to pounce. Okay, nice. Get the launch. Gonna go for the tailspin. Yeah. DP trying to get the wall. Gets the wall. It's gonna be huge damage on the wall combo. Super Kuma definitely needs this. And this is gonna be it. Yep, goes to the full combo, gets the reset, and Super Kuma bringing it back.
And the horn guy's back. French guys are woken up now. And set bomb, send magnifique.
Yes.
Allez, allez.
I know French.
That's it. 2-1. This is the opportunity for him now to ride off this momentum.
Yeah, so I think we're going to have a stage change. Yep.
Yes.
Definitely stay in chain.
When you guys are in the zone, there's a what happened, man. You just go back in.
Yeah, just, you know. Yeah, like I said, straight back in. Back in. Yeah. In the zone.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, he's going to have to wait it out a bit.
Yeah, all that momentum.
Yeah. But who knows if it could work in his favor. Maybe, you know, your heart races too much. You get a bit too much of that adrenaline pumping in. Calm down.
Yeah.
Grab your four. Fight.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, we're seeing that Kaiba has some matchup knowledge
here. Definitely.
And it seems that Feng could be, I don't know, I wouldn't say counter, but I wouldn't go as far as saying counter, but definitely it could be, yes, Akuma. But, you know, Super Akuma, coming back, and that's just getting that looks like it's a good move for him. It was too old,
yeah. Yeah, definitely wants to continue this momentum, ride this momentum, get this equalized, the set.
Just like I said, there's so much to play for. This is for number one on the leaderboard.
Yes.
And this is for a lot of money as well.
Big one. A big one that really hate everyone wants to slice.
These guys want that slice, they want that big slice.
Big slice of the tire here. So you got the crowd going hype again. So they're Kuba chance to gather the Foghorn.
Foghorn guy, legend. He's the legend of this whole tournament.
Maybe he may be the man of the tournament.
He is my man of the tournament. Foghorn guy, shouts for you. Let's get into it now. And super particular final game. First three, let's get into it.
Big hit, big second grand final in a row for the Masters.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes.
In a row.
Oh, interesting. It kind of tracks up behind him, yeah. Okay, going for that back one. Trying to get that counter hit.
Wow,
running one. Running one again. That is a high.
It's a high. Is it plus a block?
It looks very plus a block, yeah. I'm not sure about the frames, but I'm sure it's plus a block. But you can't be ducked, so you have to be very careful.
Yes.
Okay, keep up.
This is gonna hurt a lot.
And the range damage as well.
And EXP.
He actually just ran up and said, okay, I'm gonna block.
I'm gonna block.
What are you gonna do about it? And made out the EXP. He had the rage, that's what I'm saying. Sometimes in this game, it's not all about going for the rage arc, going for the rage arc drive. It's about using your range for additional damage.
And it looks like Hyper the drive is here.
And then he's just done nothing.
Just pees on it.
Yeah, done nothing, stayed there and said, all right, I'm in your face blocking. What are you going to do about it?
Absolutely. Making him make the move, make the mistakes, and better punish him for it. But this is it, match point here for Kaipa.
Yeah, in the back, get guaranteed tsunami kick. Kaipa in a commanding lead, got that two rounds, but we've seen Akuma bring it back, but...
Clutch.
Yeah, great whiff punish.
Damage.
Who says Akuma does damage?
Yeah, Feng's got damage too, yeah. Bro. It looks like that when a Super Akuma starts to play more patiently, he does better.
Yeah, it seems like he has trouble getting in, but as I say, that Feng is now all up in there.
One more mix-up could do it for Kaipa.
Doesn't get the...
He's got meter.
He needs to be very careful. Nice tempo start, and the EXDP came out this time.
But now he's used both of his bars, he's used all his meter.
He's spent all his money.
Spent it all, man.
He's gonna save up these rounds to get it back.
Here
goes that mix up. He's really just riding
down.
It. And this is gonna be it. Super Akuma
trucks
that down. Let's go, guys.
Final round. I want to see a final match. Let's get into it.
Oh, God. This is, who could call this? Super Akuma fighting for his tournament life, fighting to get into that grand final.
Definitely.
But it's not looking good at the moment.
Not falling for that mix up. Not today, sir.
No. And it's going to be a huge punish.
Yes, this is that's actually a launch punish.
Yeah, he's going to get to the wall.
Oh, my God.
Wow, look at that carry. That was from Sace. One at the end of the Sace to the other.
One more mix up.
Goes to the wrong. That could be punished.
That's all.
And goes to the dive kick. The French crowd is popping off. They're literally out of their seats.
That was a reverse sweep, Bubsy, again. Two rounds down he was. One more round for Kaipa to win. And Super Akuma says, no, I'm not today. Final match. 2-2, Super Akuma versus Kaipa from Spain.
Yeah, this is
bad.
This is actually bad.
This is crazy.
Yeah, well, we see it. Crazy Super Akuma.
Bringing up that craziness right now.
This is the final match, the final game of the losers' final.
Who's gonna take it? I don't know. Who have you guys got at home? Tweet out, Tekken World Tour. Let us know who you think is gonna win this. It's gonna be insane.
The French crowd are going wild. They're chanting for their hometown hero. We are in the heart of Lyon. Let's go.
And straight up the bat, nice damage there by Akuma.
I think he's in the zone. I mean, his offense is now working. It seems like Kai is really down in his offense now. We don't see as many up forward twos. We don't see that many down forward ones. He's in that kind of range.
But it seems like, you know what? He's tried so many back turn sweeps and they're not working.
Yeah.
Because he's staying at a range outside of that.
And that's going to be it, definitely. The crowd jumping out of their seat again.
There you go, Super Akuma on the board again.
Back dashing out. Kuiper really needs to come up with an answer here.
He definitely needs to. I think what he needs to do is get into that close range and just tee off.
Yeah, he seems really flustered. Really, really flustered.
Good tempo. He needs to bring it back down to his pace. He needs to control the game and say, you know what, play at my pace.
Great whiff punish. He's going to get the wall damage. It's going to be huge damage with shoulder barge. Lots of the baby tantrum. Yes. Block. And EXDP.
Super. Yes.
And that's going to be the round.
Nice.
Kuiper, he really needed that. He really needed to break Super Akuma's momentum there.
Yeah, because he was on 10. That was 4 rounds straight.
If he went 2 rounds down, I don't think he would have come back personally.
No, definitely not. There we go now. Akuma trying to build up that meter again.
Again, going for the low. Tatsu's DP's going to do it again.
Taking a page out of Akuma.
Here's going to be huge damage. He's going to get that stop.
Look at that. That EP for life. What a whip punish.
This could actually be the round. Yeah, this is going to be the round. He gets wall slap, wall combo, and this is going to be it.
Match point for Super Akuma.
They are going crazy. He's so focused as well. He's not getting fazed by this. I sense the biggest pop-off is Super Akuma wins this round.
This is it. This is for number one in Europe.
Nice delay hop kick, but drops the combo. Kuiper really is, he looks really flustered. He looks really shaken up.
And Super Akuma really is maximizing on that mistake.
Super Akuma really fighting off the crowd.
This is it now, Super Akuma.
Nice punish. He doesn't hook for the back turn, and that is guaranteed. And I think we're going to go into the final game.
Final round, championship round. Winner of this round is number one in Europe.
Let's go. I can't call this. Akuma does have that one bar here. He needs to be very careful. EXDP may put Kuiper off, but as you see that, gets to the wall.
This is so strong. What a start.
Gets a sweep.
No. Oh my god, now switch positions.
Don't want to be in this position. What's the mix-up?
No, he went mid.
Oh god. Oh, drops the combo himself. Uses the bar. But doesn't have the bar to cancel his own full combo. This is it. Goes for the damage. This is going to be it. Super Akuma takes it.
The combo. Oh my god.
They are all invading the stage.
This is why you need to come to France. Look at the scene. Look at this. Super Akuma, number one in Europe, Bubsy.
You know what? What's crazy is, there's still a match to play.
There's still a match
This is not the end. They popped off like this. Yeah. What did I say? I said, if Super Akuma wins, expect a pop-off. How those guys transfer themselves from the front row onto the stage. The stage is like...
These guys all became Olympic high jumpers all of a sudden.
They high jumped onto the stage.
Yeah, these guys are tied for going up the third place. Again, definitely the most consistent placing European. But then he's got an opponent, he's got a rival with Super Akuma. That's 2 times he's guys jumped up.
Yes.
Wow.
So we have the grand finals. That wasn't the grand finals, guys.
Yeah. We still got more, guys. We still have more.
Let's go to the replays.
Yeah, let's check the replays.
Yes. Woo! See that combo? Look at the damage he's getting. He's got such. He knows how to maximize his combos with the bar to get that additional wall carry.
Yeah, definitely. He knows his character inside out. Man, this guy's been called Akuma even since Tech 2.
Yes. And even when Akuma was not announced for Tekken, this guy was Super Akuma.
Yeah.
Here we go into that crazy last game. Just look at that, using the throw. We didn't really see the Demon throw that much.
No, we didn't, no. No. Exactly, yeah. We saw that he went under. He was able to beat the Demon Slayer by walking under. But
yeah.
Not that time. That was a really sick whiff punish here.
And this took it to Akuma to gain the point. And then you got the guy with the foghorn right there. Look at him.
Foghorn guy.
He gets his guaranteed shoulder bar, and then Kuiper taking it into the
final game.
Everything to play for.
And he was down. He was down in this round. But Super Akuma, one mistake from Kuiper, and he positioned him before.
Yes.
It allowed him to do this.
There we go, that demon flip.
And boom, that was
a throw. We saw that the throw was really catching mileage. And
here
we go. Look at the high jump. Look at the high jump. How that guy got on the stage so fast, I don't know.
I don't know, man. These French guys are crazy. But like, it just goes to show, like we said, the French are such a close-knit team.
Yes.
Such a close-knit team. And you know, this is what it's all about, man. It's all about having fun, you know, competing, having GGs, and then, you know, having, you know, stuff like that. It's just amazing.
Definitely.
Leon,
shout out to Leon, man.
Amazing. Every time I come to France,
always a hype. This is actually the first time I've actually been in France with Tekken.
Right. Okay.
Yeah, so I've always known about it.
Yeah.
I've obviously seen the French crowd elsewhere, but this is at home turf.
Yeah.
We're in the heart of Lyon.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Let's get into this grand finals. This is a run back from the last Masters event in German Revolution.
And we got the announcement coming from the Tekken CEO, the French CEO. So, guys, give it a listen.
Le moment que vous attendez tous.
Round 4.
La grande finale de ce Tekken World Tour Master Event. EcoFox JDCR contre Crazy Sport ou pas. The moment you've been waiting. The grand final, JDCR EcoFox versus Crazy Super Akuma.
So,
like you said, it is the grand finale.
Grand finale.
Let's get into it. This is the one. You know what? Super Akuma actually has taken games off him.
Yeah, he is a game.
Akuma. Yeah.
So I wonder if he anticipated that he would run into JDCR again and thought, you know what, I'm going to analyze that match from Revolution Derby and try to see what I've done wrong.
Now, one thing that JDCR did really well versus Akuma the last time was the side and left.
Side and low parry.
And low parry, yeah. Yeah, he did it again there, but
yeah. So I wonder if Super Akuma's taken notes from the last game and really thought, you know, I need to play it this kind of way, but JDCR off to a great lead.
Yeah, definitely. Just put it on. Going in the driving seat right now. No beating to worry about.
Yeah. That's the thing. You want to really kill Akuma before he gets that beat spin. And he accepts the all those combat combos. And so they killed him before he got the meter.
Definitely. So first round going to JDCR. This is going to be. There's no joke. We do know that JDCR is the best player in the world.
Yes.
As you saw there, that sick rip on it. But
so the thing with Dragunov has a great punish against Akuma's fireball.
Right,
if he sidesteps forward 1+2, it is a legit punish.
And 7 golden letters for JDCR. He knows this matchup. He knows what he has to do. And Dragunov, like I said, pretty good against Akuma.
He ducked the 1-1. Who does that?
JDCR does that.
Gets to the wall. Down 2.
What?
Okay, yeah. Okay, go to the mix up. Does he get the tail spin? All pass. Nice
side left again.
JDCR has that knowledge. He knows about sidestepping left against Akuma. It's really a problem for Akuma. And
yes, that was convincing.
Very, very convincing.
And what did you say, Bubs? You said it was the movement that made the difference.
Yes.
Sidestepping left. He just completely locked down. He's
like, I think that's what kind of left. When you get into that kind of tournament mode, you kind of forget things. And
yeah.
You kind of forgot about his upward two, that sidestep left evasive.
Yeah. The sidewalk left is so strong versus the demon.
Yeah.
And you can actually block
even
so you cover the
hook. It's not just strong against the demon. It's strong against
Akuma's poke as well.
Akuma's poke. Akuma does not have many pokes. He, once he, that he's, if he goes to the movement, it is.
So those, think about your jab, your down 3, those are the moves that start off his offense, right?
Yeah.
Those could be his step lifts.
Yeah. So we're in the snow, we're in Russia, Dragunov's hometown.
Russia, this is a warless edge, one of the only warless edge in this game. So I wonder. Nice.
And he ducks the 1-1. JDCR is just so on point now. He's just so ready.
Yes. And Akuma's going to have to be a bit more tight knit. He's going to have to be like, you know what, I can't get away with a lot. So I have to hit my shot.
He'll definitely take a shot. And again, stepping left. He can't sit to look to a button in the air.
Yeah.
Be very careful with those fireballs. Very careful with those fireballs. Nice. Well, standing four catches him out the air.
This is a masterclass right now from JDCR, showing how you have to play against Akuma. Gets the first round.
Yeah, he is actually just playing so on point.
Yeah.
He's giving Super Akuma little to go off.
Yeah.
He's ducking his 1-1. He's stepping his demon flip. He's stepping his poke. What can Super Akuma do in this situation?
In this situation, he's going to have to try and just play Tekken, I suppose. He's gonna
have
to try to make some mix-ups. I know you said that he doesn't have many pokes.
Again.
But he's going to have to try and do something.
Yeah, he's really going to have to, yeah, exactly, try it.
Oh my god.
There we go. This could be the start of something now. It's going to be a big combo. He's got the race damage. It was the mix up. Okay, drops a combo probably for Okazemi. Probably thought he was going to wake up into the down three.
Yeah, but James, you have the lane to wake up.
And again, sidestepping. And the fireball.
Yeah, the fireball is not saving. I think Kuma has gotten away with it on all this tournament.
Yeah, it's because Dragunov has such a good punish game against the fireball. Sidestepping.
Wow, he's just ducking all of those jabs.
Okay. There you go, 1+2 throw.
What's that, Oki?
What's for breakfast? What's for breakfast? Or what's for dinner, we should say? Is that dinner time?
That punish, that down so sweet.
Okay. Oh, and gets a stop, man. Yeah, he doesn't even have meter, sir. But yeah, James just knows he has the life and doesn't really need to do anything. And as you see, he's microseconds left and going in. Left, going in. Left, going in. And I don't think Akuma has an answer for that.
So, but you know what? At this point, you know, it's clear that Akuma's not working. He's got something
on his mind. Well, he used to play lead.
He did, but he's not chosen to go with these ones straight to stage level. I don't know, man. He should have maybe tried to change the character. Three.
Maybe he should have tried Lee at first. They played each other in Germany. So maybe he could have thought, you know, maybe
a Lee. And you know what? He has done good versus
with those characters. Yeah, the famous AO versus which ended up in both players losing their socks.
Yeah.
And that is literally both players lost their socks.
They were both playing without their socks. I'm like, why have they taken their shoes off? But this is it. JDCR 2-0 here. Looking to get a good sweep.
Tournament point here for JDCR, but Super Kuma has anything to say about it.
And we do know that he has been able to take games off JDCR.
Yeah. Hit back 1+2 there.
And what does Akuma have for standing as a holder?
He has 4 and 4-4. But they are both high. He has 4, 3+4.
Yeah.
But he doesn't really get anything off of that unless he has bar.
I think we're throwing out something like that.
Nice CP, just don't care. That's going to be punished by JDCR. That was a nice punch. I think that may have been a punish, but you need to do it a little bit earlier. I'm actually sure that would have been punished.
JDCR looking very strong, man. He just wants to win this.
He's just dashing up his face.
It's done. Over and done with.
JDCR just wants to, you know, he's hungry, wants that dinner.
Yeah, definitely.
Nice! There we go, gets the launch, the twin piston.
And that's guaranteed.
Yep, guaranteed after the focus cut.
So mix up. Nice, no parry.
He just was not having none of that. Like, yeah, no, I don't want this offense. I know what you're going to do. I'm in your head.
JDCR's had a long time to watch a Super Kuma in the loser bracket.
Yeah.
What his tendencies are.
Nice backdash. The single backdash they're making it with, but didn't challenge it.
Can Super Kuma get on the board? Yes, he can.
He uses the homing move there. That's the homing move I was talking about, the 4-3+4. Probably sense that JDCR was stepping in left a little bit too much. He kind of didn't really answer it.
You know, Kaito used homing moves against JDCR quite successfully as well.
Yeah. It's something to get him to stop stepping.
Yeah,
it gets to the wall.
Oh, the throw broke it this time.
Okay, Super Kuma just advancing with the 4-3+4. Down two. Here we go, we're gonna see the big combos against the tailspin. It's gonna be the start something huge.
The start of something
very huge. And his back dashes out.
And a teleport, what?
Yes. Super Kuma showing that he's not out of it just yet.
Yeah, exactly. You see that, you know, JDCR does get put into this situation that sometimes he gets strong.
Yeah. Super Kuma definitely wants to do this for Leon, do this for France.
He is in hometown, he wants to double you, man.
Definitely feeding off the crowd. Run up, sweep. Gonna do it again, though.
not this time.
He's very aware of where you throw the fireballs out against Dragunov.
Yeah, definitely, because he has those long range with punishes.
Yeah, great with punishes. Okay, here we go.
Trying to fix up his timing a little bit, JDCR not fighting.
Catches him stepping, and this is gonna be a launch, but no, JDCR goes for the 12 frame punish.
Are we gonna go to the final round? Yes, we are, Buffalo. Tournament point here for JDCR.
But not if Super Kuma has anything to say against it. The trench cut going crazy right now. Really backing their boy Super Akuma.
They believe him. Ale, they're saying Ale, Ale.
Ale, Ale. Yo, Super Akuma. Offering a good life lead.
And one which is not broken. It's going to be Oki as well.
Okay, what's with this
down? Guaranteed down four.
He's going to get the combo. He gets the full combo. And this could be very dangerous if he gets to the wall splat.
Oh, nice conversion of the combo.
Gets an instant while running two.
One more mix up could do it.
Be very careful. Down two. What's the mix up? Okay, and that's going to be it.
And yeah, down four,
take it. JDCR.
In Jadis Yar is your Tekken World Tour Leon Tekken Grand Battle champion.
Yes. Got the fist up in the air.
Yeah.
I like it. The French crowd clapping him off.
Yeah, definitely. They supported him all throughout the tournament.
Yeah.
Even against it was funny. They were supporting him even when Kuiper was playing.
Yeah.
Like, JDCR, yeah, Kuiper.
Yeah.
But yeah, very well played by JDCR, showing how to play against Sukuma.
Yeah, he just played. He really shut down most of them. Sukuma's off.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just by his movement. And I see so many whiff punches against the Viable.
Yeah, like, so I really think that if you want to learn how to play, that is a match you want to watch back.
Yeah,
for sure. He's sidestepped the Viables and made Akuma learn that those are not possible. I know you like to use him to sweep out, but I got a long range.
And it seemed like Super Akuma didn't really have an answer. It felt like he
round two.
Didn't
know. Yeah, like you said, that Akuma didn't have an amazing amount of hits.
Yeah.
And a lot of them are risky, right, if you get wrong. So, you know, it's like, when you get a defensive beast like JDCR, how do you open something unless you take a mad risk? So yeah, JDCR, your champion.
It's been a great experience, like, being in France here with this amazing crowd.
Yeah, definitely. Like I've said a billion times now, the French crowd is a special crowd. It's a scene in Europe which I would come back to every time because they're so passionate. Yeah. They're always supporting their boys. And I'm telling you, you know, Super Akuma vs. Kuiper, he was looking down and out. And I'm telling you, that crowd...
He made the three...
Yeah, it's a reverse sweep. Because, you know, the crowd feeds music, like, you give them energy, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, great champion.
I think we should switch to the card cam and see what's going to happen.
Yeah.
Ah, he should have been that far. We got left out. Congratulations to JDCR. Congratulations to everyone that made that pick.
Yeah, definitely, man. There was some really high matches, man. Like, I don't know if you guys, I'm losing my voice.
I've lost my voice. My pro actually hurts.
Yeah, my pro hurts, man. Like, it's been crazy. There's so many final rounds. So many hype comebacks. Everything here, man.
Yeah. We've had them. We definitely had that treat. We've had a round which was just run off a hell sweep.
And we've had upsets as well. I mean, who would have thought that third could be
Tishimon? I'm not certain we didn't get to see that.
Yeah, I mean, Tishimon not making top 8 is something that no one really thought would happen.
And we had Harry Potter.
Harry Potter, yeah, losing the second black and someone else.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he didn't make it into the bracket either, so I don't know. It's
like we said this before, we cannot call the
fight. Round 4. Fight. Round one. Fight.
And the winner of this Tekken World Tour Master Event, Echo Fox GDCR, is running away. Congratulations! And this is the end of the Tekken Ground Battle 2K17. Thanks for watching, and then we'll see you next year. Ah, merci à tous! Ah, merci au Tekken World Tour! J'espère que vous avez passé une journée fantastique! Et on sera de retour en 2018 pour un événement encore plus pété, je vous le promets.
KO. Round three. Fight. Fight. two. Fight. Round four, fight. Round one, fight. Fight. Round one. Fight. KO. Round two. Fight. Round one. Fight. Round three, fight.